I work on the superfamily Scarabioidea, otherwise known as scarab beetles. And as you can see here, many are quite obvious, colorful, and easy to find. However, there are many more that are cryptic, hard to find, and considered quote unquote rare. In my experience, many rare scarabs are only rare because we don't know where to look for them. For example, when you look in microhabitats such as rotting logs or wood, that's a great place to find supposedly rare scarabs. Sifting leaf litter is also a great way to find rare scarabs and other beetles. On the left, you can see Bob Anderson, our resident expert on leaf litter sifting, doing his thing in Cuba. Other colleagues seen here are in the process of finding rare leaf litter scarabs in Chile and Peru. A lot of scarab beetles are dung feeders, so I look for microhabitats such as this latrine pile left by a herd of guanaco in southern South America. Here we found several species of scarabs rarely seen elsewhere. It's also a good idea to get close and personal with burrowing mammals. Their burrows often contain dung piles and concentrations of other organic debris that are a treasure trove of scarabs that you won't find anywhere else. Social insect nests are another great place to look, especially ants and termites. Here, I am searching through debris from a termite nest in Roatan Island, Honduras, where we found a number of rare species of scarabs. I will be giving you a few tales of rareness from Cuba, Canada, and southern South America. Three regions where I have had comprehensive biodiversity survey and inventory projects on scarab beetles. Starting in Cuba, I described the species Phylophaga sarlacca based on a series of specimens I collected there in 2013. This species had never been collected before and has never been collected since, which led some to say, wow, that must be rare. I actually think it isn't a rare species because if you look on the far right, you can see a big pile of Phylophaga sarlacca, so it wasn't too hard for us to collect over 200 specimens in 2 nights. Holguín province in Cuba is poorly known entomologically, so any perceived rareness of this species is probably due to a lack of field work in this area. Fricius costellatus is a genuinely rare species that is endemic to Chile. I have examined over 50,000 specimens of scarabs from Chile and have only seen 2 specimens of this species. This specimen is the type from the National Museum in Santiago. And this second specimen on the left was collected by Charles Darwin during the voyage of the Beagle in the 1830s. I know that this species is still around because every once in a while, somebody finds one and gets very excited and posts pictures on the internet, as you can see on the right. But I have been to the area where this species occurs, and several Chilean colleagues have been there numerous times and have basically turned up nothing. So I think this is a genuinely rare species that probably warrants conservation status. Leosimodius indefensis was another supposedly rare species that is endemic to Chile. And for 90 years after it was described, it was only known from around 10 specimens. However, knowing a little bit about this group, I knew that you would have to go and find sandy habitats and use specialized methods to reliably find more specimens. So on an expedition to Chile, I specifically targeted sandy dunes and beaches where we sifted sand, took the debris that was sifted out, and stirred it up in these buckets of water to shake the beetles loose. Since the debris generally sinks and the beetles float, you just need to watch the surface of the water and pick out the beetles as they float to the surface, and you can see the size on the right. Using this technique, we found hundreds of specimens of Leosimodius indefensis in many different locations. As you can see here on the map, the records we found represent at least 1,500 kilometers of Chilean coastline. So we were able to publish our findings in a review of the Ophidiine scarabs of the region, correcting that this species is actually extremely abundant across large parts of central Chile. There are also rare species in Canada. Cetodius edmontonus was described in 1929 based on 3 specimens from Edmonton, and no additional specimens were ever recorded in the scientific literature. Edmonton is not a hotspot of endemism by any stretch of the imagination, so I was skeptical that this species just occurred in Edmonton. Of the over 90,000 specimens of Canadian scarabs I've studied over the past 15 years, I only found 4 more specimens of this species from 2 localities west of Calgary. So this is definitely a rare species, but it's not quite as restricted in distribution as previously thought. The rarest Canadian scarab beetle is Flaviellus cluanensis, which I described a couple of years ago. The description was based on only 5 specimens, so these 5 are the only specimens ever collected by anyone. This species occurs near Kluane Lake in the Yukon. I don't really know what the exact microhabitats or feeding habits of this species are, so it would be great to get up there and do some more field work and research to see how rare this species really is. Thank you for listening.